Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. Welcome to the second lesson in my Google Tag Manager series. In the first lesson, we covered how to get started with Google Tag Manager. And in this video, we're going to look at how to add additional tags to our container. We're going to add a Google Ads remarketing tag, a Google Optimize tag, and a Facebook pixel. Okay, so we're going to start by adding the Google Ads remarketing tag to our website. So let's head to our Google Ads account. To set up our Google Ads remarketing tag, we select Tools and then Audience Manager. We can see in my demo account that I haven't created any audience lists yet. So we can set up a new audience to create our remarketing tag. If you'd like to use an existing tag, then just select Audience Sources on the left. And then look for the Google Ads tag. Let's select this option. We're going to select the first option that allows us to create an audience list for people that have been to our website. Then we just need to follow the steps. And we're given our Google Ads tag. We can then select the option to add the tag using Google Tag Manager. And we need to copy the conversion ID. Now we can head to Google Tag Manager. We need to create a new tag. And let's name the tag Google Ads Remarketing. Now let's select Tag Configuration. And choose Google Ads Remarketing as the tag type. Now we just need to paste our conversion ID into the tag configuration. And now we need to add a trigger to our tag. Let's select All Pages as our trigger. This will add the Google Ads Remarketing tag to all of the pages on our website. We can now save the tag. We're going to add another tag. This is the conversion linker tag. This can help improve the accuracy of your Google Ads tag because it stores information as a first-party cookie for our website. So let's create another tag. Let's name the tag conversion linker. Now let's select tag configuration and choose conversion linker as the tag type. We're going to leave all of the default settings and we're going to add a trigger to the tag. Let's select All Pages again. And let's save the tag. We've added the Google Ads remarketing tag and the conversion linker tag. Now we're going to add Google Optimize to our website using Google Tag Manager. Google Optimize allows you to run experiments on your website to increase conversions and engagement. And you can also use it to present personalized content to your visitors. We're going to add the tag in just a moment, but if you'd like to learn more about Google Optimize, including how to get started and how to create an experiment, then I've included a link to my tutorial in the description below this video. Okay, let's head to Google Optimize. To implement Google Optimize using Google Tag Manager, we need our Optimize container ID. Here we can see I've already opened my Optimize account. So we just need to select Settings. And then we can copy our container ID on the top right corner. Now let's head to Google Tag Manager. Currently, we need to configure our Google Optimize tag based on an existing Universal Analytics settings variable for Google Analytics. We covered the steps to add a Universal Analytics tag in the first lesson. So if you need to pause this video and watch the first lesson, I've included a link in the description below this video. Okay, so we can see we've already created a Universal Analytics tag in Google Tag Manager, so we should be okay. So let's create a new tag. Let's name the tag Google Optimize. And let's select Tag Configuration. And let's choose Google Optimize as the tag type. Now we need to paste our Optimize container ID into our tag configuration. And we need to select our Universal Analytics settings variable. This should also be the Universal Analytics property you've linked inside your Google Optimize account. Now let's select Advanced Settings and change the tag firing options from once per event to once per page. Now, importantly, we're not going to add any triggers to the tag. This is because we're going to fire this tag based on our existing Google Analytics tag. So now let's save the tag and confirm that we want to save the tag. Now we need to open our existing Universal Analytics page view tag. And let's select Tag Configuration, then Advanced Settings, and Tag Sequencing. Now we need to enable the option to fire a tag before our Google Analytics tag fires. And now we need to select the Google Optimize tag we just created. And let's save the tag. Okay, now since we're using Google Tag Manager to implement Optimize, it's important to add some additional code to your website. This is because Google Tag Manager loads asynchronously, which can cause your content to flicker as it loads. I've included a link to the anti-flicker script in the description below this video. Now let's take a look at my website to see this. Here we can see the code that is added to all of the pages of my site. We can see the Google Tag Manager container, and above this is the anti-flicker snippet. When you add this snippet, it needs to be just before the Google Tag Manager code, and you'll need to make sure your Google Tag Manager container ID is included in the code. Again, I've included extra details about the anti-flicker snippet in the description below this video. Now it's time to add the Facebook pixel to our website using Google Tag Manager. Let's head to Facebook. I've already opened the Facebook Business Suite for my page. And now we need to open the Events Manager. So let's select More Tools. And now let's choose Events Manager. I've already created a pixel for my website, but we can see it hasn't collected any data yet, so I'll need to add the pixel to my website. If you're getting started for the first time and you don't have an existing pixel, then you can select the option to connect a new data source. And then select Web. And then Facebook Pixel. Since I already have a pixel, I'm going to close this. And for our existing pixel, we need to select Add Events, and then From a New Website. Now let's choose the option to manually add the pixel code. We're now given the pixel-based code to add to our website, so let's copy this code. And let's head to Google Tag Manager. Now we need to create a new tag. Let's name the tag Facebook Pixel. And let's select Tag Configuration. And let's choose Custom HTML as the tag type. Now we can paste the base pixel code from Facebook. And let's select Advanced. And under Tag Firing Options, let's change Once Per Event to Once Per Page. This will mean that the Facebook pixel isn't fired multiple times as someone is browsing a page on our website. Now let's select Triggering. And we're going to select the All Pages trigger. This will mean that our Facebook pixel is added to all of the pages of our website. Now let's save our tag. We've now added the Facebook pixel. So that's how you can add additional tags to Google Tag Manager. What tags are you going to implement using Google Tag Manager? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you'd like to continue learning about Google Tag Manager, then if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel. Next week, I'll show you how to preview and test your tags to make sure everything is working as you expect before you publish your tags. And in another future lesson, I'll also show you how to track conversions using Google Tag Manager. This is useful for Facebook and Google Analytics 4 or GA4. I'll see you in the next video.